Roadwide clear.
Hunter's on standby. And forget the frequency.
123.85 for the ATIS. Wind 0106, visibility 10, sky clear below 12,000. Temperature 22, dew point 16, altimeter 3002. Visual approach to runway 1 in use.
3002.
1432 closed. Altitude restricted, low approach is authorized. All taxiways
winds 21016 are closed. So that's going to be
runway 14 Papi out of service, runway 32 Papi out of service, runway 14 real out of service. All taxiway signs non-standard.
No, I've got that thing here. Should I start writing stuff down or
taxiway Delta near taxiway
Bravo? I get the important stuff.
Initial contact. You have information, Oscar.
This is the wind again.
Information, Oscar.
Waco Regional Airport, information Oscar, 1451 Zulu weather. Wind 0106, visibility 10.
You're going 0102, right?
Temperature 22, dew point 16.
Little difference.
Altimeter 3.
So that's coming dead north then. Almost.
Visual approach to runway 1 in use.
So 3002, information Oscar.
32 close.
Winds 001, 010,
so 10 degrees.
All taxiways.
10 degrees, 0106.
Runway 19 are closed. Runway 14,
it's going to change the grounds where I'm listening to him.
121.9. Real out of service.
121.9.
Okay, and what are we showing on the MAC compass here?
Showing 020.
Okay. And here that we look on the tag again. Flight adjustment there. There we go. And flaps up before we call for taxi.
Flaps up on the left, up on the right.
Okay, so you're going to give them a call, get their attention first. I am going to start putting in the radios more. You did just fine with it last time we flew. Get their attention first. Waco ground, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot. They're going to acknowledge you. Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, Waco ground. Okay, where are you? You're at the T-hangers. Where we want? We're going to McGregor's. We're going southbound. At the T-hangers, southbound. What do you want? Radio taxi. If you have time, or if you think of it, throw in, we have information Oscar. You know, I always do that, but I also know if I don't say I have it, they're going to ask me. So one way or another, that's going to get covered.
Okay.
But ideally, with the ground, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, go ahead. Yes, sir, we're at the T-hangers, VFR southbound, information Oscar.
Request.
Just tell them what you want, that's it. When you tell them you're southbound, they understand your radio taxi. And then they're probably going to tell you one via Delta, but I'll reiterate that once I tell it to you. So get their attention first.
So Waco Tower.
Waco Ground.
Waco Ground.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot. Okay, and then you respond. And then once they respond, you're going to say at the T-hangers,
Skyhawk 1080
VFR Southtrot,
Waco Ground. Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, runway 1, taxi via Delta.
1 via Delta, 80 Foxtrot.
Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, new weather just came out, wind currently 33010, altimeter 3002.
80 Foxtrot, roger.
Okay, so the wind's 330 now, so it's a little bit...
Yeah, it's moving back and forth out between the north and northwest.
Alright, so brakes, parking brakes off.
Foxtrot, say attention. Skyhawk 80 Foxtrot, roger.
I said we're going to be southbound into the pattern, but better. Okay, so the wind is in front of you from the right, so remember, climb into, dive away from.
In front of me to the right, so.
There you go.
Aircraft information
station Papa Current, altimeter 3002.
Right here. Not really marked too well right here though. It's not marked very well, but I still try to stick on this side of it. Just because it's rough around the airplane to taxi through the tie-down area, you've got all the little divots where those tie-down rings are buried. And you're dragging your nose wheel through them and dragging your tires through them. Taxi the cub through there, and it sounds like you got a midget back there beating on people out with a hammer when you hit up the tail wheel.
Okay.
They're going to end up having to build a temporary hangar out here somewhere for this airplane. It's got a lot of damage.
Does it?
The hydraulic system is messed up pretty good. The obviously the landing gear beyond just the tires. It's bad enough that they're talking about bringing the original manufacturer in to do the work and not just the mechanics of L3. Alright, so he said one via Delta, Black's where you're at, right?
Yes.
So we're on Delta, so on around.
I bet that's going to be an expensive job.
Yep, it is. I imagine. Especially given the original manufacturers in Italy, if you got to send a crew from Italy to work on that thing. They're just, they're Waco to do the avionics upgrades.
I like those tie-downs they have.
Yeah.
Golly.
I don't think it's going anywhere. It turns out they did land short. There's a little, you've been too busy to notice it when you've been flying, but on the threshold of the runway is a concrete lip where the threshold lights are mounted, and they drag the tires across the concrete lip. Well, the lip sticks up about this far, so they hit it broadside with the tires. They're surprised it didn't knock out the other side.
Oh.
Now the wind's behind you from the right, so dive away.
I can feel that wind pushing us.
Yep. Okay, red and white runway in sight, so we'll do our turn up here a little closer to the shoreline.
Should be about right there.
Yep, man, just straighten the nose wheel out.
Alright. Hey. We got full movement.
Hey.
Alright, so now up on the right, up on the left. Elevator up and down. Have rudder. Set our altimeter, compass, fuel selector on both. Never did lean it out, did
we? Yeah, we're gonna need to lean it for best power for sure though once we're at run up power.
Alright, so
go ahead and run it up to 1700 first. And then go ahead and wing it for best power. Sustained 1700, then four cranks in. It's a little cooler, so you can see mid of the wind very much.
Magneto check, going to the left. 50
50 RPM drop. More to the right. Same drop. Operator heat. Got a drop. We're good on the ammeters. Good on the suction. Temperatures and pressures in the green. Suction gauge good. We're gonna throttle down to 1,000. All the way idle. Drop, back to that. Turn our strobe lights on now?
Yes sir, strobe and landing.
All right, and the radios are...
Let's go 119.3.
Back and turn around now. Shut both trim
and the flaps
set.
Are where we think
flaps
they are
up and the carpet's off.
Cool. All right. Waco Tower, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, where are you? Runway 1, what do you want? Ready for takeoff.
Waco Tower, King Air Bravo Tango on the VOR 14 circle.
It's going to be Waco Tower, 80 Foxtrot. I can't hear
you.
After the full
new guy, right? Circle west of the field.
Oh, Waco Tower.
One,
yeah,
one,
so whenever you break the ice, full tail number.
Circle west, left down with clear lands. You're about now.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Waco Tower, runway 1, cleared for takeoff, and make a right wind, right downwind departure.
Clear for takeoff, right downwind departure. He's having us do that because it's an airplane doing a practice IFR approach to runway 14, so that gets us on the opposite side of the airport of him. Because he's coming over here.
Clear on final.
Clear.
Final. Alright, one more time, we're on both, flaps are up, we're set trim, RP's in.
Cool.
We're good to go, aren't we?
Let's do it. Heels on the floorboard, here we go. A little bit of left-hand control wheel for that crosswind. Almost said stick because I've been in the J3 so much lately. Continue our climb at 2,000 feet, and I'll show you why on the way over there. told you, and unless he says something else, there's no need to report anything.
Traffic 7 on 213 Charlie Bravo. 109 on the runway 36.
Go ahead and turn toward this end of that little short runway. That puts you just about squared up to the runway. And by convention, if you're going to cross over an airport...
Over traffic, Cardinal 8084, Bravo, left cross, red runway 33, full stop, Weaver.
The best way to do it is midfield, because that's what people expect you to be.
Okay.
So just like every other thing we've done on a non-tower pattern, we're setting ourselves up to see and be seen. So we're holding our altitude 2000, we're on our way into a pattern. Let's go ahead and run our GUMPS check. Remember your GUMPS?
Yep, gas on both, undercarriage is down, mixture is set, and power is set. Power and shoulder belt. Seatbelts and shoulder harnesses.
A little low on my altitude.
Yep.
2,000 foot puts it gives us 500 foot padding. We like that padding.
Runway, runway. Three. Cleveland. Waiver traffic, Cardinal 8084, Bravo, turn to left base runway 334.
Everybody's off work and not flying today.
I bet they are.
Okay, now I'm going to announce that we're crossing midfield.
Traffic, Cardinal 8084, Bravo, on outpoint the runway 33. We make a northeast departure climbing 1,500 feet.
Lots of non-tower airports on the CTAP today.
McGregor traffic, Buddy 57X, race taxi in from the west, ramp 36 for departure, McGregor.
Wind, turning downwind for runway 15, to 17.
Okay, so we're crossing the field right now. You can square it up a little bit more. A little bit of a, like, 5-degree right-hand turn. We're going to keep on going for about a mile. That gives us room so that when we hold your altitude. But when we finish this right 270, we're in about the right spot for a downwind. If we just turned right now, we'd cross the runway the other way and never be in a downwind.
We're going to go this way into the downwind.
Okay. We can make that whole turn a descent down to pattern altitude as well.
I see.
Now could we just hang a left and enter a downwind? Yeah, but we don't have nearly the visibility that way.
I see.
And we don't have nearly the time with that wing high to make us visible.
Right. Alright, is that about a mile?
Okay. Go ahead and roll her into that descending turn to 1,500 feet. And I'm going to announce that we're teared up into a downwind.
What do I want to go tell my RPM?
Just a nice... easy descent, you know, 1900, 2000.
7X race departing runway 36 to the north, McGregor. 35, yes, sir.
Is that a steep enough turn?
Yep. Got a good view out here, got the runway coming around.
2542 is on upwind of runway 35, McGregor.
Make her run around.
Should have started it steeper, shouldn't I have?
We could have gone a little bit further, but it worked out pretty well. You're almost spot on for a downwind here.
Okay, we're turning left crosswind for 3,000 still over here.
A little close. Yeah, we can work for that. Alright, coming up on your touchdown zone, gear set up, car peaked, power 15, flaps 10, do you verify the speed below 100?
Alright, we're below 100.
Take a deep breath, loosen up all those big joints, get back in your seat.
I do feel a little tense today for some reason. Alright, there's my...
little bit more flaps out there. Matter of fact, let's go full flaps. We're in the white arc. We're good to go. We're high. We need to address that with the power. Idle the power. Trim your nose up. We need to slow this to about 65. Still about 10 knots hot. Berker on down, looking good. Good sight picture, good track end. Keeper coming downhill. Keeper coming downhill. Keeper coming now, slowly level, looking down that runway, looking down the runway. Add the flare, 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 flare. Don't let go of the back pressure, your wind's from the left. You lower that right wing, what's gonna happen every time? Then you go the wrong way. Laps coming up, car peak coming off, let's go around. Good touchdown, we just wanna make sure the correct wing is down. You were probably looking pretty close to the airplane on that one. How's your wrist?
I feel it a little bit, but it's not bad. I think I can keep going. Good.
Okay, standard pattern now. So 1,200 feet, then crosswind, continue 1,500 to downwind.
Again, I was a little rough after I hit the ground. I don't know what I'm missing there.
Your eyeballs are right out in front of the nose instead of at the end of the runway. That's what it's looking like. That's why you didn't have the right wing down. Or the correct wing down, rather. He's on the runway right now. We do our gumps check on the downwind.
Alright, gas on both, undercarriage down, mixture set, power set, seat belts and harnesses.
Okay. And we're going to get blown towards the runway every downwind because we've got a left crosswind. So we need to fly the airplane slightly away from the runway. Touchdown point, car peaked, power 1500, check the speed, laps 10. But you don't need to be thinking about that, you need to be looking down the runway. Look where you're supposed to and your body knows what to do. As we turn final, we'll check our speed inside the white arc. It is, and we'll go full flaps and look for a speed at 65.
Traffic, runway falls, 5 mile final, runway 17, we're low approach, only Taylor.
keep my nose coming downhill.
Need a little power, don't I?
Nope. You're good. Keep us coming downhill. Alright, slowly level us, looking down the runway. Look down the runway, look down the runway, look down the runway, look down the runway, look down the runway. Let me show you something. First off, power. Where's your power right now? Is it idle?
Yeah, it was.
Now it's at idle. You're not going to land with it not at idle. And look at all that back pressure. Follow through, wind, into the wind.
Alright.
Follow through.
Alright.
Alright? Here we go. Feel that nose up trim, but just pull the nose where you want it. And then you can adjust that if you need to. That one was straighter, we can get straighter still.
Okay.
And follow through.
I was looking down the runway a lot better that
time. Yeah, you were. Little follow through is going to go a long way now, just like a golf swing. Think about a baseball swing, there's a reason they don't count a check swing as a strike, because there's no way the ball's going to go anywhere.
Right.
But you don't follow through as a check swing.
Okay. But look down the runway and follow through.
Yep.
My wing was in the wind better that time.
It was. Yeah, like I said, half the battle's looking in the right place. look down the runway, just level it, let it sink a little bit further. Idle the power. Flare, 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 follow through all the way over to the left of the ailerons, all the way back to the control wheel.
What do you have on the back?
See what I'm talking about?
I can keep on the center line here. Good deal, I like that one.
Uh-huh. Do that again.
Are we ready?
I'm ready. Keep it straight. Whoa, whoa. Look down the runway and steer the airplane.
Not the wind that did that?
Nope. That was Brandon that did that.
Okay.
The hell of a thing about an airplane is it does what you tell it to do.
There you go, I blamed it on the wind again.
Uh-huh.
Okay, traffic, SMC 2542 is starting update for runway 35.
If you continue to look down the runway in your takeoff roll and continue to keep a little bit of stick into the wind, it behaves itself very well. If you don't have that stick, don't have that stick a little bit into the wind, that's hard to make it track straight.
Gas on both, undercarriage down, mixture set, power set, seatbelts and harnesses.
Good.
Cleveland traffic, Tumble 83 Alpha Tango, Dawn Smith, floating at takeoff. Cleveland traffic.
Did you go flying this weekend at all? You go on a birthday flight?
No, we just up too late on Saturday. Hung out with some friends.
Saddamill, big jump point 90098 X-rays over the field, descending through 5,000.
All right, we're below 100.
Like 8 hours in that cub last week. Oh, Lisa.
Really?
The last thing I wanted was to sit in that cub for another hour.
I see.
I love flying that thing, but 8 hours in a week here at that crossbar in that back seat leaves a mark on you. Okay, full flaps, let's move on. Yeah, any more than about 4 or 5 hours in that airplane in a week, and you're like, alright, that's enough. Get beat up in that back seat when that window's open. It is rustic. Okay, speed a lot better. We're about 5 knots slower on this one, so we're getting a lot closer to our target speed. Keep the nose downhill just a little bit longer. Now slowly fade to level, and now keep the back pressure coming. Make it mush. Make it mush, make it mush, make it mush. You look close to the airplane right before touchdown there, then you straighten it out. Follow through, all the way left, all the way back. All the way left, there you go. All right, I got your carpet and your flaps. Real good approach except for the last 5 or so feet. You quit looking down there and you start looking right here. Am I right?
Yes, you're exactly right, you're good.
The airplane talks to me.
Undercarriage down, mixture set, power set, seat belts and harnesses.
Alright, keep the eyeballs down the runway and follow through. There's nothing close to that nose for you on short final. Everything you want's down the runway.
Seat belt traffic off 5-2-100 Victor. Currently 8 miles from the southeast.
Have your vultures look when they're running and approach?
You're looking at the box.
What happens if they're not looking at the box?
I don't know. I mean, we've always looked at the box. There's nothing, you have to kind of look at the box. That's.
But what happens if you don't? Probably miss it.
Yeah.
In the runway is the box.
Downhill, a little bit longer, a little bit longer, a little bit longer, a little bit longer.
Downhill, downhill, downhill. Now slowly begin to level it. Level it, step itself down. Now come in your flare, kill your power. Look down the runway, look down the runway, look down the runway. The right wheel touched first, but you immediately straightened it. Why? Because you're looking in the right place. Muscle memory is forcing you to do the right thing. Go around. Look down the runway. A little bit of sticky on the wing like you got right there, it'll track a whole lot straighter. Nice.
That one was okay, wasn't it?
Yeah, we touched the right wheel first.
Your right base,
but
17,
because you're looking at the right place, it forced you to straighten it. We're gonna do one more on 3-5 since I got a little final exam for it. I'll put you in a little bit more crossway and a little bit narrower runway since we got it here. I don't know.
Still got power. A little bit, didn't I?
Got an idle there, it's not good.
Dang it. Alright, car beat off. We're gonna circle around, we're gonna enter a left downwind for 2 feet. I'll talk you through that. Gotta be in the habit, when you go to flare, feel that power and make sure it's idle. I'll just let you go through the motions on that one. What happened every time you caught a flare, it ballooned again.
What?
Still had power.
Had much power, okay.
You gotta get rid of that power when you go to the flare. Other than that though, it was okay, right? Still touch right wheel first. I'm not pleased with that.
Alpha Tango,
so if you want to touch right wheel first, I'm going to put you in a runway with the right crosswind.
Okay.
Oh hell, okay. We're just going to set up for a downwind for 3-5 first, and I'll post back around the right side of the airport, we'll end up on runway 22.
So we're going to do the same thing we've been doing?
For now.
Okay.
I'm just setting us up for a different runway.
good little right crosswind. On the ground on 3-5, he's no factor. We're going to park here for us a normal left pattern. But you're on the ground, check your killer before you go. Alright, into the wind. Ready?
unit traffic, Piper 2027 echoes right base for 19.
Horseshoe Bay 929 Sierra Gulf is on a right base, runway 17 Horseshoe Bay.
You're attempting to give up for 2, crossing runway 422, back to the runway.
Alright, gas on both, undercarriage down, mixture set, power set, seatbelts and harnesses. Just another runway. Longer.
Franklin, Central Zero, one Yankees, 4 miles north, clear to approach runway 17.
Understood. here, you can make this turn directly to a downwind and point us at the twin bridges.
Just, you know, turning left downwind, yeah. Leaving the pattern.
Yeah, left downwind 2-2 for a northeastbound departure for the pattern. That way they know I'm not gonna fly a landing pattern, I'm just using this as a way to point myself where I wanna go. And we can level at 1500 this time, because the tower is just gonna take us in whichever downwind they want. There's no real potential to have to cross midfield or anything back at Waco. Touchdown, which the good thing is your flare height is almost always where we want to be. That's real consistent. We just gotta make sure the right wheel is earthbound. I keep saying the right wheel, the correct wheel is touching down.
So I've gotta get more in that Dutch roll position before I
let her go. You can't wait until you're on short final to do it. You gotta have that wing down the entire final. Said there was McGregor Tech and Scott 80 Fox trying to part in the area to the northeast. Last call, McGregor. That way they know, okay, I'm done with y'all. We're done. And then I'll wait until we're almost up here on the bridges to get with tower. Got a little bit of precession on your hanging thing here. Mostly because we're on and off that power so much. Remember, this is vacuum operated and the vacuum pump's tied to the engine. So up and down the engine means up and down that vacuum pump means it just imposes a lot of drag on that gyro.
I hope Troy can fix that.
That's annoying. Now, your radio calls up had you do it been good, but it just, like the little things that I'm doing out here in McGregor, I know you can't hear.
I mean, I've heard a lot of that on YouTube and stuff. I have a little bit of idea what's going on, but it'd be nice to hear them for repetition purposes.
Yeah.
Track 100 Fox Charlie Wake Tower.
Track 100 Fox dropped. Wind 350 at 6, altimeter 3002. Make straight in runway 1, clear to land.
Alright, that's easy enough.
Yeah.
We're still set here. To go to up McGregor. Something easy to steer to. Yeah, you don't even really realize it yet, but I'm giving you references like that to show you what works and what doesn't for checkpoints. By the time we get to where we're doing cross-country stuff, you're gonna have a pretty good little database of the kinds of stuff I've had you look for.
Uh-huh.
And none of it's little.
Okay. Are we gonna go back and practice stalls and S-turns and that stuff, or are we beyond that now?
We're beyond that for right now. We're doing stalls every time we land right now. We'll do one more stall series before I solo you, just to verify that if you were to get yourself into a stall with the pattern, you're going to be alright. But more than anything else, all that stuff was used to teach you how to handle the airplane for what you're doing right now. Now we're going to have to go back and rework all that stuff so you can demonstrate it on a check ride, isolate it out from the stuff that you're combining it for right now. But, you know, we've achieved the safety and the aircraft control means for the time being.
So I'm going to try and anticipate when the downwind would be and the base leg and all that.
Yeah, you can go ahead and do gumps here.
Alright, gas on both, undercarriage down, mixture set, power set, seat belts and seat harnesses are on. So I'm going to, the final would be about the start of that island.
Normally, yeah.
And the base would be about where that water changes colors maybe.
That's a little bit wide for a base. I'd say just, you got a PAPI system, right? You got the lights right there, fly the lights.
Okay.
So we're slightly high right now. Okay, well if we bring our power back and our carb down and our flaps to 10, that probably sinks us into that, and then we'll set the power accordingly. It's fly the approach lights.
All right, we're below 100 now.
We're not always gonna have that luxury, but when we've got it, it's a real handy guide to use instead of having to sort of make stuff up in your head.
Uh-huh.
Looks like a left crosswind now, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Now, what is the range on those PAPI lights?
As far as how far you can see them?
Uh-huh.
If you're the right altitude, you can see them for...
No, where does it pick your plane up at?
It doesn't pick your plane up anywhere. It's an angle thing. There's louvers in those lights.
I see. I get it now.
Add a little bit of power and hold yourself on the glide path. Two right, two whites, two reds is what you want. Three reds, you're slightly low, so a little bit of a power increase will fix that. There you go. That's on glide path right there. We held this approach path all the way in, and we would touch down right on the 1,000-foot markers. Now we'll be a hair short of them. Now we'll be right on again. See how you got two reds, two whites?
I need to put more on the flap?
Yeah, go ahead and go full flaps. Now we're close enough, we're going to say, okay, well if we want to continue visually without the lights, we can. That nose coming downhill. Look down the runway, left wing low, use your rudder pedals to straighten the airplane up. As you level it, idle it, and begin adding your flare. Now straighten that nose up, straighten the nose up.
Power's all the way out. How'd I get that little balloon?
A little bit fast,
I guess?
Still hot.
A little hot?
Okay. Go ahead and make Bravo here.
Okay, 0 Fox Short, contact ground point enter.
Yeah, we'll do that once we're off and cleaned up.
Well, that's a squirrely feeling whenever you're up like this and the yep, your back end's like that.
We don't worry about that, we worry about where we're looking. Make the airplane go where you want it. Go ahead and bring us to a stop. We're gonna go landing light and strobes off. Out the transponder on standby. And we're gonna go 121.9. Waco ground, Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, new guy now, so a new number. Clear of one on Bravo.
Skyhawk 1080 Foxtrot, Waco ground, Texas parking via Delta.
Park via Delta. Anytime it hangs in ground effect and even gives that an opportunity to happen, that tells us that we're hot. Now glance down at where your trim indicator is set right now.
Down, isn't it? So
yeah.
That's why.
Okay.
You're right. Somebody comes in and tells me they're having problems with their flare. That's the first place I look. Where is that trim indicating when they shut down?
So yesterday, when I was coming home from the airport, going home, there was three or four jets waiting in line on runway 19.
Uh-huh.
And there was another one back taxiing, you know, about to get on in line as well. What were they waiting for? I've never seen that many jets waiting in line at this airport before.
Well, you can only take off one at a time.
But why is so many flights leaving at the same time is what I'm saying.
There's
a lot of people leaving.
It's a free country, I don't know.
For Waco Regional? That's a lot, it seemed like.
Hey, it's the border region's getting out of town before we all show pitchforks and torches. I don't know, you have random busy times and random slow times. I don't really think about it anymore. It's one of those things that just is what it is.
Well, on the whole, what do you think? Not a bad day.
The touchdown has not been bad. We just, you know, I'm starting to show you some things we need to work on. Now we're getting to a point where we're not concentrating as much on what that flare is. You can see we've got to start working a little bit more at being on some sort of glide path, you know, so we're not high all the time, because not every runway is as long as 17 over there is or 19 over here is. We got to work that out as we continue strengthening this skill set, and we got to make sure that we have the power to idle on touchdown. Got to make sure that we've got that wing in the wind, that nose straight. Clear.
Thank you, Aaron, once again. Check it. The other stuff we're going to continue to work on operations and work on landings.